surprising, because it's actually the opposite of what most people believe. You see, when most people think of speakers or trainers or seminar leaders, they think of this perfectly polished, perfectly sounding, perfectly looking person on stage with the perfect vocabulary and the perfect gestures and the perfect hair, although mine's not too bad, and the perfect on and on and on. I mean, come on, you are on stage in front of hundreds or even thousands of people. You better look and sound as perfect as possible. Yes or yes? And the answer, of course, is no. No. Training secret number one. Be authentic. I repeat. Be authentic. To be a great teacher or trainer, you have to truly be authentic. Authentic is 1,000 times more important and more impressive than perfect. Let me repeat that, because again, it is not what most people think, and it's not what most others teach. In short, you have to be and sound like you and only you. No airs, no ego, and absolutely no perfection in the way you look or the way you speak. It's perfectly okay if you say you stumble, or even forget what you're talking about. In fact, really great trainers don't try and memorize everything. You know, when I train, first of all, I use a music stand with notes right in front of me to guide me, keep me on track, and keep me on time. And I hardly memorize anything, except for one part, which I'll tell you about a little bit later. And you know what? I don't pretend to try to memorize anything. And if I'm away from my notes, and I get a little off topic, and I forget what I was, you know what I do? I ask the audience, hey, what were we talking about? And you know what? They tell me, and we laugh, and we all work together, and it's all good. And no one cares that I'm not perfect. In fact, they welcome it. Why? Because they are not perfect. No one is perfect other than, say, in the spiritual sense. And just the idea of perfection makes people uncomfortable and not like you. And that's not just on stage, my friend. That is everywhere in life. True or true? And the word that they use is slick. So, trying to be and look perfect actually works against you. Because, first, as we said, it's impossible. And second, everyone knows it's impossible, so they wonder what you're really like and what you're hiding behind that mask of perfection. Your perfect appearance, your perfect words, your perfect smile. And third, as I alluded to earlier, your supposed perfection reminds people of their own imperfection and brings up their insecurity. It's subconscious, but they feel it, and in the end, they just don't trust you. Does that make sense? So, what's the answer? Authenticity, and here's a big one, vulnerability, which is really just another form of authenticity, yes or yes. Again, I'm not trying to be perfect up there on that stage. I'm being me, the best of me, but still just me. I'm going to talk the way I talk. I'm going to walk the way I walk. I'm going to tell people my stories of how things didn't work out for me and how I messed up. And I let people know that I actually have weaknesses. But you know what? They don't care, because they know that I'm real. And consequently, they know that what I say is also real. Does that make sense to you? Regardless, there's one thing that the audience will know for sure. They will know it in their heads and feel it in their hearts and in their souls, and that is that when it comes to my topic, I know what I'm doing, I know what I'm talking about, and that I can really help them. And that is all they really care about. Let me repeat that. That is all they really care about. The truth is, they don't really care much about you. They care about them. And that's not selfish. That's just human nature. So what if you're not perfect or polished or even good looking? None of that affects their life. What's important is what you are teaching
the knowledge and information you provide and what result it's going to have for them. Yes or what? Yes. It boils down to this. When you are not authentic, your audience, they can smell it. Sure, they'll smile and they'll clap for you at the time, but just assure they will never buy your product or come back to learn more from you. On the other hand, when you are authentic, when you are vulnerable, your audience relates to you and they connect with you. And that connection, my friends, is what moves them. It's what gets them to trust you and want to learn more from you and pay for that additional learning. Very good. And that ongoing relationship is one of the key ways you create success and wealth in this business. And if I'm your mentor, that's exactly what I'm going to teach you to do. Connect with your audience in a way that they... by stating it in the form of a declaration, and then we're going to make it physical. Why? How many of you understand that everything is one? Energy. What's the word? Energy. Yes or yes? And that all energy has its own frequency and by what? Vibration. True or true? And so every time we make a statement, that statement has a what? A vibration that travels not only through your entire body and your being, but into the universe. So it's important that we say it like we mean it, and that this is already true for us. And afterwards, we're going to give ourselves a high five and say, I'm an awesome trainer, to ingrain that too, okay? Now, of course, I know this sounds a bit hokey, but I strongly suggest you actually do it as part of this course. It's powerful because it's physical, and listen closely, physical is memorable. Physical is what? Memorable. Good job. Okay, so here we go. Repeat after me. I am authentic. Let me hear you. I am authentic. Now give yourself a high five and say, I'm an awesome trainer. Woo! I'm an awesome trainer. Good job, everybody. Well done. Okay. Now, the next few secrets that I want to give you are part of what we call the introductory template. And I want to focus a good portion of today's web class on this area. First, because it's critical. And second, because many of these techniques will continue to be used throughout your entire training. But since these elements start during the introduction, we'll put a lot of our attention there for today. Good or good? All right, so here we go. Secret number one. Two, you must standardize your introduction. Let me repeat that. Standardize your introduction. Basically, your talk or training is always going to have three. How many? Three main parts. The introduction, the teaching or the body, and the conclusion. Yes or yes? So at this point, we're going to discuss several parts of the introduction because your introduction is a lot more important than you might think.